Disclaimer, Joss, Jules, and Nevermore are not professional therapists. They will be sharing their personal experiences and advice, but this is in no way a substitute for professional help. There is also a good chance of swearing, tears, and triggering conversations, so listener discretion is advised. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Slaying Demons, a podcast about facing your fears in life and being the best version of yourself. I am your host, Jocelyn, and joining me, as always, are my wonderful co-house. What's a co-house? Oh, Jocelyn can't freaking talk today. Joining me, as always, are my co-hosts, Jules and Nevermore. My demon should Hi. Be Annunciation. How are you ladies doing tonight?
Hi, Joss.
Hi, Joss, you can't talk.
Oh, man. I don't know why. I've had a ridiculously terrible sleep record in the last, like, week or so. I just have not been able to sleep. I've had so much on my mind, and I've been just, like, thinking about all these silly, crazy, oh, my God, overwhelming things. And, like, last night, I was like, okay, I'm exhausted. It's 9:30. I'm going to go to bed. I ended up going to bed at 11 and then laying in bed going, I need to organize Taco. Oh my God, I need to email all these people. I have so much going on. I need to figure out all this stuff. I have new shows I want to start. And my brain just went shabloo. And I went to bed at 5 a.m. I had to get out of bed, and I started, like, I made a calendar and I made new show notes for a new show, and I made a thing for the Taco volunteers, and I emailed them all, and I was just like, I just need to work because I can't sleep. So I feel like that's probably just snowballing into why I can't talk right now, is I have not a lot of sleep in my face head, in my face head.
In your face. This is going to be fun.
I know.
Oh, man. I'm being so good right now.
You can always tell it's the start of the show when we're being good, but yeah, I'm sure it's going to devolve over the course of the next hour. So yeah, that's basically been my week over the last week, is just a whole bunch of thoughts swirling in my head about a whole bunch of things, which is going to lead into my demon. But did you ladies have a good week? I don't want to get too heavy too fast.
Yeah, it was, you know, it's been a week. It's been a week of, I actually went to the Renaissance Fair here in Minnesota, which was awesome. You know, fun experience to go and hang out, you know, with a bunch of nerdy people. And I got like myself nerds. A henna tattoo on my arm. And so.
You should show people.
Wow. It's hard to see. I look like I'm flipping people off. But. so it's a phoenix. Like, I look like I'm flipping you off. It's a phoenix and it's upside down. But it's I look like I'm trying to be like, we can fix it. Yeah. You
know? I get that reference.
Yay. I'm so proud of you.
So it was really fun. I mean, we were only there for a couple of hours because it had rained there. And if you had been to a Renfest before, it's usually all dirt roads. And it rained so much that the middle of the roads were all muddy, like super, super muddy, like ponds of water muddy. So everybody had to bottleneck onto the sides. And it was just so frustrating. I was like, okay, I can't move. There's so many people. And, but it was a gorgeous day. So I had a good weekend. But I'm like Joss, I haven't been able to sleep well. It's been like 10 months that I haven't been able to sleep well. And it was really bad this week. Like, I can't sleep.
Maybe there's just like weird juju.
I think there is, actually. I've been kind of reading about that. So yeah, there kind of is. I don't know how much hokiness you want to get into.
But you know, I can explain get some of it. On us because we're going to have a really interesting conversation. We're going to have a really interesting conversation a little bit later on in the episode with our listener feedback. So I feel like that this is probably the episode to get a little bit out there. Why not?
So if you're into astrology, which I'm not, but I've been hearing about this like crazy, is that right now Mercury, the planet Mercury, is in retrograde, which apparently means that everything in the world decides to go backwards, shit ass stupid. Everything breaks.
Because the planet said so. I'm not making fun.
That's a technical term. Okay.
Yeah, it is truly a technical term. But it's like things don't work right, or like people like come out of the blue from like the past and want to talk that, you know, I mean, hi, that happened to me.
Yeah.
You know, like technology doesn't work and travel plans get screwed up. Communication sucks. And it's like, and it's till like the 23rd or something. And it started like the beginning of September. So it's been like this for like weeks, and it interrupts sleep too. So that's what I was reading. And so apparently if you're into astrology, there you go.
See, okay. I'm not, and I'm not going to poo-poo anyone's ideas or beliefs, obviously. The only thing that I kind of maybe could see would be the influence of the moon, because like science, gravity, like moving water, that makes sense to me. So I can see how that might potentially affect things. Like I was laughing at my roommate at first, but the more I thought about it, the more it made sense. His wife was actually due right around the full moon, and he was like, she's just gonna have the baby on the full moon. I'm like, that's bullshit. And he's like, well, no, but if you think about it, the baby's floating in a big ball of water, and if all of a sudden that's affected even a little bit, it could just go shabloosh, baby. because that's how it happens, right? So, oh, you know, that I can kind of see, like, all right, maybe ish, science-y ish.
Yeah,
but
it's, you know, and it is what it is. I've been, all I've been doing is reading, he's seeing things that have been saying this particular thing, and like weird shit has been happening to me lately, and I'm like, okay, whatever. But like I will, you know, I will believe that there are things out there that I can't understand, and that there are no real, you know, tangible explanation for. But yeah, so it's probably, if you're having weird shit happening to you right now, it's probably gonna keep going for at least another week. Sorry.
Hashtag blame Mercury.
Mercury's a bitch.
Yeah. So does that mean that I can blame my demon this week on Mercury? That my, and actually, no, I totally can't. I can't even pretend to, because this is a problem that I have struggled with for a very, very, very long time. And I feel like it's another installment in the Joss is a Crazy Person series. So, but, and I also don't think it's as simple for me as a lot of other people, because I feel like there's a lot more deep-seated issues here than just straight up, I don't like to do shit. But procrastination is my thing that I'm going to talk about this week. And like I mentioned, it's not a new thing. It's something that I've struggled with probably for the last, like, I want to say maybe since like university, I think. So about 10 years or so, maybe a little bit more than that. Something in my system just went do. So if everything just like randomly shuts down, then hashtag blame Mercury. And
yes,
just as I say, that's kind of a load of shit. I'm just like, oh, wait, my technology's not working.
The universe just flipped you off.
Exactly. Oh, man. Okay. But yes. So with my procrastination, basically, it's like I'm overwhelmed and I realize that, but at the same time, like, I have this, and I think it actually almost might kind of feed from a lot of the stuff we talked about last week too, with the disaster thinking. But it's like I think of all the things that could happen if I did the thing, and all of the things that could happen if I did the thing, because these always are things that I'm late on. Like the deadline is already passed. Like I can usually do things like if I get it done before the deadline, it's awesome. And I can usually do that. But if it passes the deadline, then I freak out and I'm just like, okay, it's now at the point that if I do it now, then people are going to know that I'm really late. But if I just don't do it, then as long as nobody says anything, I can't and insert all these crazy disaster thinking things here. So,
yeah,
for instance, I'm going to say a thing now and no one's allowed to judge me and chat room is not allowed to yell at me. But I still haven't done my taxes. My taxes were due in April. April. Like, I haven't done them because the deadline passed. And now I'm just like, well, I know I don't owe the government money. So no one's going to come knocking at my door because you have to actually like make money to owe them money. And right. I didn't make much money and I paid them a shit ton. So I know that I'm not in any kind of like actual legal type danger. And so now I'm just sitting here and it's like every day it's like this horrible, oppressive like thing that's weighing on me. But I'm just like, if I don't do it, no one's going to know. Like if I just pretend I did it with everyone else, no one's going to know. There's 35 million people in Canada. What are the chances that the government's noticed?
I can visualize every feeling you're having. Like because I've had it, you know, and questions for you in that respect. Do you get really stressed out when deadlines are pending?
Not so much.
Are you very much a rule? Like, I need to make sure I hit this deadline no matter what, or is it more like I'm just, you know, I'm upset after I miss a deadline?
I think it's more upset after I miss deadlines, but I'm also not that great at just organization in general. I'm good at, which I know is probably going to give you a bit of a panic attack because I'm organizing your Hearthstone tournament for Well Played, but it's really funny. Like stuff like that, stuff where I feel like there are other people depending on me, those are deadlines I won't miss. Like I will organize the shit out of whatever it is that I have to do for somebody else. It's when it's just me where I start to let things slip and I start to not be able to organize and I start to feel really overwhelmed. But if I'm like, I have to do this for X person, then I'll be fine. So it's this really like, it's like I'm constantly letting myself down and saying like, you're not worth it, Jocelyn. Your shit can wait. You have to do X, Y, and Z thing for all these other reasons. And I'm always finding reasons to do other things. And this isn't like I play too much Warcraft or I, you know, do other stupid shit instead of doing the things that I'm supposed to be doing. Like I'm doing a whole lot of the other things that I'm supposed to be doing. And especially now that I am my own boss, like it's almost like it's snowballing now because being my own boss and creating my own content and doing my own thing is, I feel like not as important as doing the shows I do with other people or making sure, you know, like whatever the thing is, I'm always putting that ahead of the thing that is now my job. So it's getting to the point where it's really bad. Like, for instance, if I was doing the show by myself, it probably wouldn't get done. But I have you guys. So I'm like, okay, Tuesdays, I have to do the thing.
Yeah, because you'd find something else to fill the time or you'd just, you know, say, and it's, yeah. But you've got that obligation factor. And, you know, if you want to get really deep about it, it's about your own level of self-respect. You know, you're not treating yourself like a customer.
No.
And you could, I mean, you know, you could do that, but then how do you shift that mindset? Is it physical money? Is it like you pay yourself physically, you know, to say when you do this job, you get paid by, you know, putting money in a jar?
I don't even think that would work because I know when I do my taxes, I'm going to get a huge influx of cash because I'm basically going to get all my income tax back because the way that the taxes work, it's like, they take when I had a job where I worked for somebody else, they take a certain amount of money, and that's based on your income from the year before. And because I quit my job in September, that means they were taking money based on my income for 12 months, and then I only worked for 8. So I paid income tax and didn't have an income for 4 months, basically, because expenses of moving and everything else. So anyways, I'm going to get a huge chunk of money, and it's going to be very significant. It's probably going to pay for BlizzCon. And I'm just like, I'm still not doing it. Like, it's stupid and ridiculous. And I'm a crazy person.
No, you're not crazy.
That's super hilarious, because you're like my Canadian spirit animal, because I'm exactly the same way.
Are you?
With my stuff. I have this huge to-do list, and I'm a super procrastinator too. But what's funny is I'm like, oh, I need to get all my Etsy stuff listed. I need to do this. And Jocelyn's like, I'll do that for you. And I'm just like,
and I totally would.
Like, volunteer for me. And then I'm like, well, let me help you with all your stuff. Like, I want to help you. Like, I want to help you with, you know, get nailed and all this stuff. So we're totally like wanting to do it, but not for ourselves. We want to like help everybody else
dig into that,
store all our own stuff.
Dig into that, because that's really, really, that's a huge realization right there.
I didn't
seriously
even think about that,
because I was like thinking, I'm like, you're so crazy. Like, I mean, it's like overwhelming. You have to get all your pictures, you have to do the little blurbies for it, you have to upload it and list it and stuff. And she's like, I'll do it, it's not a big problem or whatever. And I'm thinking, like, that's a lot. She's busy. Like, what is she talking about? So the fact that you're saying that, it's that's why I've been smiling this whole time, because I'm like, you're nuts.
But and that's not the thing. I will absolutely do, like I said, the same thing to Garrett when he was doing CreateCon. I, you know, like the jobs that I take on for Angry Chicken, I'm running the taco tournament. And, you know, the fans, it started out just as like us doing a fan tournament and me organizing it in the background. And that was it. And then we started casting the finals. And now fans are like, well, where's the stream? We want to stream. So I'm like, of course we can do a stream. And now I have to be streaming all day on a Saturday. And I'm just like, give. Here, have all of my time. I want to make you guys happy. And then I'm just like, I haven't done my taxes. My desk is a mess. I'm a disgusting slob. I haven't done laundry in a week. Like, but it's just like, those are things for me specifically. And I'm just like, nope, I don't have time for that. I have X, Y, and Z, and I can clearly help Nevermore do all of her stuff. And I can't right? post my own shit. I've been wanting to do, so I had a show, you guys know, but I don't know if everybody who is currently listening to Slaying Demons, because I know we're pulling from a whole different audience, but I had a show called Joss versus the World. And I really loved it. But it was a ridiculous amount of work, because it was basically looking at a different competitive game every week, going into the PvP portion of it, learning it from a pro who I had to schedule. And then it was a 2-hour stream, and then usually about a half an hour talk afterwards of all the things that we learned and pointers for new players and stuff. It was a great concept. I really liked the show, but it was so much work in the background. I just couldn't do it anymore, because it was only me and having to try to, there were a couple of different reasons, but having to try to schedule a pro was really, really difficult. A lot of these people had no idea who the hell I was, had no idea what a podcast even was, and didn't really understand the concept of then taking a stream and a podcast and smooshing it into one. So there was a lot of like marketing and promotion and explanation just to try to get to people, like just to try to get people on the shows. And then, I found we weren't getting to the stuff that we really had to, because there was just so much to learn when you're picking up a new game. So every episode, like we did one with Heroes with Kyle, and, you know, he was trying to talk me through stuff, and it's just like, oh my God, I have an hour to condense Heroes of the Storm into something that's relatable for a new player, and you just can't do it.
Yeah.
So I did five episodes of Joss versus the World. I didn't even post the last one because I had so many problems editing it that, again, I had essentially like missed the deadline. I was like, oh yeah, I'll have this up Monday. And Monday came and went. And then another Monday came and went. And now I'm like, I can't do it now because people are going to be like, what the fuck is she doing posting her show like 2 weeks after? And then 2 weeks became 3 weeks, became a month. And then I'm just like, well, I just can't post this now. So, I had, and then I just kind of let it die. And I've been saying since, I guess, before CreateCon was about 6 weeks after I stopped doing the show. I was like, no, I'm going to post an update. And first I was like, okay, I'm going to post a vlog. And now I'm like, okay, maybe I'll just put a blog post up. Maybe I'll just send out a tweet even. And I haven't even been able to do that just to let fans know, because there were probably about 1,500 people listening to and or watching this content. And I just dropped it. I just let it go. And I've been like procrastinating putting up this update to say essentially what I've just said in the last 3 minutes of what the fuck happened to Joss versus the World. But I'm just like, I can't sit down and do it because I don't know, Joss crazy reasons.
So what made it okay for you to say it here?
I don't, because I'm sitting in front of a mic. This is like, I'm already here. I might as well
you've gotten to this point. Yeah. And so what would stop you from literally clipping this and putting it out there?
Well, and nothing, except for then I know it's going to go on the list of things that I have to do. And it's going to be like, clip audio out of Slaying Demons, put in Joss, not Joss Plays feed, Joss versus the World feed. And even that, I'll just be like, I don't know. It'll get lost.
I have a serious question.
Deprioritized? Unprioritized?
How do you keep your to-do list? Is it post-it notes? Be honest. Is it post-it notes?
I absolutely hate the idea of just to-do lists because I find that they don't help me. They overwhelm me. And that was part of the problem. I started with no to-do list, and then I was actually forgetting completely to do things. And then so I was like, okay, I need reminders. So then I started post-it notes. And then within a week, my whole entire double monitor setup was post-it notes. And so every time I tried to do anything, I was seeing the 50 other things that I had to do as well. And then I couldn't concentrate because I was like, oh my God, okay, I have to do this, and then I have to do this, and then I have to do this. And I got way overwhelmed. So now I have a calendar that is up on my wall that tells me when all my shows are, because those are like the do not miss it, do not fuck it up, can't miss it things. And then on the side, I have all of my bigger like projects that I have to work on. But from a day-to-day standpoint, like I'm just putting out fires all the time. Like I'm just like, oh my God, I got to do TAC, which means I have to play some Hearthstone today because I haven't played Hearthstone in a week, and I have to read all the Reddit, and I have to watch all the videos, and oh my God, it's 4 o'clock. Okay, do the show. Yeah. And then, you know, like, okay, that show's over. All right, well, I need to eat because I haven't eaten yet today. Okay, shovel food in my face. Hi, Matt. I love you, honey. Aww. Let's watch that 70s show while we eat. And then, oh, yay, show prep, Slaying Demons. Go. Like, make sure Nevermore has her shit in the notes. Like, make sure that everything's where it needs to be. Make sure, you know, do sound checks. And then, oh my God, I totally forgot that I was supposed to talk to Jules because of Hearthstone things, and then have to call Jules. Like, I just feel like my whole entire day is always putting out fires. And then so I feel like that's why I've thrown myself into Legion so much, because I don't have to put out fires there. Like, Legion Joss has her shit together. She has her leather working mount week one. Like, Legion Joss is good. She does shit.
Yeah. Legion Joss is on top of things.
Exactly. And then I like that I'm on top of things. And because, like, I felt like Legion was a fresh slate for Warcraft Joss, you know, like, so I could get ahead of things, and I am ahead of things. And then people are coming to me and asking me questions, and I'm giving advice, and I'm like, I like this. But I feel like I'm so behind on everything in my life that real life Joss can never be like that, because we don't get like a shabam, clean slate. And I'm never going to catch up on this shit.
Well, and I think, you know, when you're describing that you're feeling like you're in control in Legion, you're given tasks to do.
Yeah. Direction.
Yes. Quest lines.
You're given direction by the game, you know? And I know that there's a ton of apps out there that if you had, like, you could literally kind of be like the quest giver for you. Like, this week you're going to do this and you're going to do that. That it actually pops up and says, you have to do this first, you have to do this next. And I'm wondering if that kind of thing, if you gamify it a little bit like that, if it helps.
That actually might work. And then have like daily repeatable quests or weekly repeatable quests of like,
oh my God, do if Discord tech now. Made a calendar like Google calendars, but it was integrated in Discord where you could share it with other people and they could like be like ding, 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 and like light up something for you and be like, you're supposed to be doing this. I see you playing WoW. Like, oh my God,
yes,
come on Discord.
Yes.
You're going to be the thing that like takes over the world. We're waiting for you. Come on. Mm-hmm.
I know there's an app that does exactly this and I have to go find it because I can't remember what the name of it was.
I know that there's one where it's almost exactly like WoW where you like have your little person and you can like set your quests, but I like wouldn't set my quests up. So I stopped using it. It was horrible.
Night Vale in the chat room has just posted.
It's called Quest Level Up Your Life on the app store. So it's you have an iPhone. It's called Quest Level Up Your Life.
Neat.
Ooh. Thanks, Night Vale.
See, we're supposed to be sharing resources with the community, and the community is sharing resources with us. I love you guys.
Yeah. No, see, Night Vale knew what I was talking about. I've heard this, and it's if you, and there's the other one, Habitica?
I think that might be one I've heard of too.
Yeah. So take a look at both of those because maybe this is the checklist that you need to kind of, you know, have your app be your quest giver.
I love how the little like tasks all have like a bad guy that like that's who you're fighting. That's
Can
cute.
I just fight myself? Because I feel like I'm constantly fighting myself. But yeah, and Habitica also is being mentioned by Hachikumo in the chat room. Says it's a video game to help improve your real life habits. It gamifies your life by turning all your tasks into little monsters you have to conquer. So same sort of thing, except for Hachikumo is saying it's a website, which I think I might prefer because another one of my problems not really problems, but something I do on purpose is I don't have my phone with me during the day. And I try to do that because I'm like, OK, if anyone really needs me, then they can grab me through Discord. Otherwise, you know, like it allows me to focus a little bit better. So I don't have my phone right next to me. It usually just stays in the bedroom. So, which I've been bitched at by some co-hosts in the past because they're like, I was trying to get a hold of you all day. You didn't answer Skype or your phone. What's wrong? And I'm like, I hate Skype. It's never open. And my phone's in the other room. And I literally totally missed a patron hangout because I had totally forgotten about it. It was a monthly thing. I'd totally forgotten about it. And I was upstairs and just didn't get the messages. But I feel like a website would be helpful because that's something that would be at my desk and more in my face than my phone. But I have also decided as a result of episode 1 of Slaying Demons, I think I'm going to spend my birthday money on getting an Apple Watch, which will help me because then I will just have buzzing on my wrist as opposed to like once I pick up my phone, I'm just so like, I got to be on Twitter and I got to talk to all my friends. And like, I get way, way too off track when I have my actual phone. But I feel like I won't do that on my watch because this is lame. I don't who's going to sit there and do this? Like, I just need it to remind me of shit, like what time it is.
Yeah. I'm actually going to get an Apple Watch too. Yeah. After I saw the
Look
new one come
you
out.
Fancy guys. Yeah. Damn it.
I know. I know. This is my gift to myself.
Birthday money. Are you going to use your Apple Watch as your fitness tracker or are you going to keep it separate?
No,
I thought you were ordering a Fitbit.
I returned it. I got it. Like,
Nevermore.
It delivered on the day that the new Apple Watch was announced. And I'm like, screw it. I'm returning this thing and I'm getting a different thing.
How much is the new Apple Watch? It's a lot, huh?
It's a lot. It's like 360.
That's not bad, because how much was the Fitbit, like, fancy
150.
So it's about double. I thought it was way more than that. Mm-mm.
But the reason I decided on, because fitness, basically I needed something for fitness and organization, and I feel like the Apple Watch is going to fill that void very well. And so from a fitness standpoint, like, I did need something. And so, I feel like if a fitness thing is worth $150, then the organization of my life is easily worth the other $150. And I got a chunk of birthday money because I asked everybody for money this year because I was planning on buying a gaming laptop. And then I was like, Jocelyn, you're 32. You're ridiculous. You're not going to be a pro gamer. What's wrong with you? That's a stupid waste of money. Don't be stupid. So I didn't waste my money. And now I'm going to be fit and organized instead of a pro gamer because you can't be a pro gamer when you suck at games, guys. You just can't.
Well, you're a pro podcaster, so don't even worry.
But yeah, so anyways, that's where the decision slash money for the Apple Watch came from. So, but yeah, so that's my demon this week is general procrastination, especially when I've already missed a deadline. Then that's pretty much like full Joss crazy time and freaking out about all the terrible things that are going to happen to me if I do the thing, because then it's like that's the big problem is like I know what life is like without doing the thing. And I wake up every morning and nothing really bad has happened. But if I do the thing, people are going to know that I'm way late and then people are going to be mad. So I'm just going to not do the thing and maybe no one will notice. That's my demon.
Demon acknowledged.
Thank you. All right.
Definitely.
Jules, what is your demon this week? Because I think Nevermore and I pretty much share the same
one. Are you the same? Nevermore?
Mine was going to be procrastination, and then I saw Jocelyn's, and I was like, damn it. And then I'm like, well, I'll just play off hers and then talk about how, like, healthy stuff's going and all that. And it's the same stuff. It's the organizing and the keeping track of everything. I just want to say I'm super proud of myself. I had a salad for lunch, and on the way home, I was, like, starving because I had a salad for lunch. So instead of pulling through the drive-thru, I stopped at the grocery store and I bought the little things of like pre-cut fruit, which, yeah, they're more expensive than buying actual fruit, but I'm not going to actually cut it myself. So I bought a couple of those and some bananas and stuff like that. So, yeah.
But good for you.
We'll let Jules go in a second. But speaking of procrastination, this is all to pack up Jules's box that is still here because this weekend we were really busy. We had... I can't even remember what Saturday morning was, but Saturday morning was I had to end up working because when we get behind at work, our boss asks us to work on the weekends, which is not fun. So I did that for a half day. And then my sister actually had to go to like a sale, like a resale thing for kids stuff because she put some of her things for sale there. But she won like $100 credit. So they had to go because it was like a free $100 on clothes for my niece. So that was like north of where we live, where she's like more east of us.
Yeah.
So she's like, hey, I want to go, but they won't let kids go. And she talked her new husband into going with her. So she's like, can we drop Ellie off at your house? So we have my niece all Saturday nights, which was a lot of fun because she likes to come see her Obi Ben and Auntie Nevermore. And she's still, Jocelyn, I swear to God, she came over to my computer and she saw my new microphone. She's like, hello.
She thinks I live in the computer.
Because I let her talk to her once. It's hilarious.
That's adorable. Yeah.
So we had her, and then Sunday, we were just busy, and then I took Ben to go see the Who's Live Is It Anyway, the comedians who do Who's Line. It was just a busy weekend. So anyway, long story short, I still have Jules' package, even though I gave her shit last week. I'm like, your stuff's going out, blah, 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 whatever, and it's still here. So that's my procrastination thing. And dude, right, I feel bad about stuff like that, so same things as Joss. Okay, what? Jules, your turn.
Oh, no. This guy's got the right idea.
Me hit the oh, mine.
Right, hang on, Jules. I forgot to turn off Twitch alerts, so Ryan just resubbed. Thanks, dude.
Yay!
Thanks,
Ryan.
Let me go turn off Twitch alerts, because god damn it, that's going to be in the recording of the frickin' episode.
Way
to go, Ryan. You just had to push the button.
Of course. That's totally awesome. I love it.
Oh man, why do I suck so bad at life? Like, I don't understand.
Well, you know, when you suck at life, you laugh at yourself and then it's not so bad.
We're laughing, right? We're all laughing. Joss can't even podcast properly, apparently. All right, alerts are off. We should be good. Fuck my life.
You're fine. Please don't worry about it. I mean, it happens. That's life. I mean, shit happens and you laugh and you say something dumb or you do something dumb and you're like, yep, I'm here for your amusement.
Twitch alerts is the putting on the pants of podcast.
Except I need them off instead of on.
Opposites. Yes.
All right, so now that I have totally, completely, and utterly derailed the show, Jules, why don't you tell us a little bit about your demon this week?
So mine's a little bit different from what I've been doing in the past couple of episodes. And this one has just been a frustration of mine. I have been told many, 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 many times that I need to learn how to meditate because I have a monkey mind. And anybody who is a creative or is a self-motivated person or does work for themselves knows what monkey mind is. It's literally just you. You do. You do. Because all it does is the monkey in your brain swings from tree to tree to tree. And it's every thought that you have. Well, you just described it before. Mm. You know, that crazy thing where you're just like, I need to do this. And if I don't do this, then I don't do this. And then this. And then this. And the monkey just goes, woo, woo, woo. And it's awful.
So the monkey is what's not letting me sleep.
Yes.
God damn it, monkey.
The monkey is literally swinging from thought tree to thought tree and back around. And it's so they call it monkey mind. And so it is, and I cannot stop it sometimes. And so I have been told so many times, I got told yesterday, you need to learn how to meditate. And so I had been given this advice about an app, you know, really cool app. I think it's called Insight Timer, and it has opportunities. It's things for guided meditation and stuff like that. And help it all this really cool stuff. And so I couldn't sleep last night. And I said, I found a meditation that said it was going to be helpful for restful sleep. I listened to this thing and I'm like, fuck this. I cannot stop thinking. Like it drives me insane. I get so frustrated because it's telling you, breathe in and feel the air within your body. And I'm like, no, I'm thinking about the fact that I forgot to brush my fucking teeth before I went to bed. That's what keeps happening. I know I'm very sweary right now because I'm so frustrated by it and I don't know how to shut it off.
Well, and I can totally, I can see that because I know for me, anytime I've ever been told to, you know, calm down, stop thinking, basically, whatever type thoughts I'm thinking at the moment, it's just like, okay, so I calm down, I sit here, I be quiet, and then 10 minutes passes, and guess what? I'm no closer to getting everything done because I've been sitting like a dumbass bitch not doing anything.
I
find that's a really, really big hurdle when you're trying to calm your mind is just taking the time to actually let it happen.
Yeah. And it's the struggle back and forth with the things like I know I need to calm my mind down, but I have so many other things that I could be doing with this time. Mm-hmm. And it's very frustrating and it's very, or, you know, and a lot of times, so what I do to calm my mind is I will watch something on Twitch, like just something mindless, or I'll have just a music on in the background while I read Reddit or BuzzFeed or something, just reading, you know, I read so much. But it's still stimulating my mind. I'm thinking, I'm reading, I'm understanding, I'm, you know, processing, I'm all of that stuff. And it's just like, Joel, shut up. Like, I just want my brain to shut up. And, you know, meditation is good for stress release and sleep, you know, problems and all of those things, you know, just getting centered and calm. And I know it's good. I literally cannot make myself do it because I get so angry that I can't. Like I'm so, and that's another part of it. I don't like when I can't do stuff.
Yeah.
Like, you know, that feeling like
you're Joss like, understands.
Competitive Joss completely understands. Like you think you should be good at this. Mm-hmm. You think you should be able to defeat this. I mean, this is just, you know, it's literally shutting your brain off. How hard is that? And I can't do it. It's then I'm just like, you suck. You're so lame and blah, blah, blah.
And then you have a negative thought spiral on top of all of the other stuff that you are already jumping from thought to thought to thought. Yeah, I understand that for sure. And I mean, at least what I can say about your demon this week is at least you're trying to pursue a healthy path to try to solve this problem. Because I know for me, I take the totally not healthy route and I drink. I'm like, okay, I need to shut up my brain. And I find that's why I started drinking. That's why I still drink. And it's literally like whenever I get to the point, and it's probably because I've stopped drinking for, they're not completely, but stopped drinking as much as I had been drinking for money and health reasons. I was just like, you know, I'm feeling like crap because I'm drinking way too much almost every night. So I've slowed down on what I'm drinking. And I find as soon as I slow down on my drinking, then up comes the insomnia because of the thinking. So thinking or drinking, I can do one or the other. And neither one of them is in a good place. So I commend you for finding a positive solution to, or at least working towards a positive solution to the thinking too much problem, because it's one that I have and one that I do not solve in a healthy manner. I use whiskey or I use wine and it's not good.
And, so you know, I've done it.
The meditation thing isn't working. Like you said, you keep getting distracted. Are you still looking into other options, or have you found something that's kind of starting to work, or what have you found out now that you've been looking into it since, you know, people keep telling you you should?
Well, you know, and it's been leading me down a path of, you know, leading me to finding things like why are weird things happening right now? Mercury is in retrograde. I've been reading, I'll be completely honest. I've been reading about everything, you know, gemstones and, you know, the power of gemstones just to see. I mean, I am really thinking about a ton of stuff because there's clearly my brain is clearly in disturbance mode. And mainly it's because I think I've been in fight or flight mode for about 10 months. Mm-hmm. And so I'm reprogrammed. I'm literally reprogrammed right now where it's just like my brain is constantly on alert. And how do you just like, I have to unlearn that. I have to figure out how to unlearn that when I've been doing it for 10 months. And that's like, they say you do it for something for 30 days and it becomes a habit.
So what happens after 10 months? Yeah,
correct. And so, you know, I've been doing everything from, you know, looking at meditation, and just trying to read, about the psyche of fear, and of being stressed. Like, what does stress do? The constant reminder to me is you have to learn how to meditate. And I'm like, no, I can't. But really what happens that is my, what's happening to me is I'm in stuck thinking mode, and stuck thinking mode is literally saying I can't. And it's not that I can't, it's that I don't want to.
Mm-hmm.
And I realized that today. I kept saying, I can't. No, it's not that I can't. It's that I'm afraid to. Mm-hmm. Because if I can shut that off finally, what happens then?
Mm-hmm.
You know? So that's where it gets deeper. You know, it's like, so if you ever sit there and you say, I can't stop doing, that's actually not the reason. That's not real, because it's a stuck thinking thing. It's just, it's part of when we get stuck and just believe that something is yes or no, that's not usually the case. I can't do this because, well, no, you could, you just choose not to. And so that's the, you know, like I said, we're getting kind of deep, but
deep is good. That's why we're here. We're here to get real, get deep, talk about things that sometimes people go, oh, I don't know if I want to talk about that. And even like you admitting like, okay, I'm looking into alternative therapies. I'm looking into things that, especially within our circle of friends, there are a lot of our friends who are extraordinarily nerdy and who are very sciencey and who say the science of crystals, it's fucking carbon, Jules. Are you insane? Yeah,
exactly.
So just opening yourself up to that kind of talk and those thoughts and, you know, like it's very brave of you to be sitting here talking about that. And I think it's great that you are exploring other avenues, because in the end, if it works for you, then who cares if it's scientifically right?
Yeah.
You never know what'll help you until you try. You know, you can read all the things you want, but
yesterday I had a psychic hand me these two crystals and said, take these and carry them with you. And I said, okay, well, you know, it's not going to hurt me to carry them with me. So
unless you sit on it the wrong way, then you're like, damn right. it, now I have a bruise. Psychic.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah. Thanks so much. And so, cause I went to this store that was, you know, in here, it was like a new age store. I was looking for anything, like just, you know, calming remedy or something. And there was a psychic in the store and she, you know, was so freaky. She said, "You were married for 7 years, weren't you?" And I'm like, "Yeah."
Okay, that's pretty specific.
And then she said, "You met him at work, didn't you?" And I went, "Yes." And so I was like, "Whoa, okay."
And Jules is like, "I'm listening." Yeah,
so, yeah.
I mean, they're wearing a TTT shirt and you're like, yeah. "I'm on to you, lady."
I got you.
Yeah, we think that she's a psychic, but really she's just a Jules fan. She's really been stalking you for like 4 years.
This whole time. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you know, I will freely admit.
I'm gonna get her with this psychic thing.
Right? I will freely admit that there is a lot of, you know, skepticism in the world about all of that. And I know a lot of people have skepticism and I have a healthy dose of it too. But when someone looks at you and they can say those things with, she's never met me. And I'm like, okay, whoa, like, that's crazy.
Well, it's got to give you pause at least, right? Like, I mean, anyone comes up to you and starts telling you things about yourself, you're just like, okay, wait, what? Yeah. Like, and so I don't think there's anything wrong with exploring and questioning.
Yeah. And sure. She's the one that said to me, you need to start meditating. And she's not the first. I've had so many who have. And so it's just like, okay, well, you know, I tried it yesterday and I gave it a 2 middle finger salute because I couldn't sleep last night again. So, yeah.
Have you tried, I know this is another thing that some people do and some people don't. I don't use it, but have you tried essential oils? Like, do smells help you?
Actually, they did send me home with one of those types of things too to actually put on my pulse points for sleep. So I tried that last night and it did calm me a bit. Like, I didn't feel as anxious, which was good. In my time where I was, I had an accident a couple years ago, a car accident, and I actually explored acupuncture because I couldn't get relief from the whiplash that I had. But acupuncture was really helpful and they used essential oils on me too. And it was like, I had like the weirdest experience with acupuncture. So,
my mom is a ridiculously huge believer in acupuncture. She's been going for probably, I want to say like 15 years now because she had ridiculous migraines that were almost monthly. Yeah. And she did chiropractic for a long time and that helped a little bit. But then she started going to acupuncture. I think she goes once every like 6 months now and like has a migraine once every couple of years. Like she's full on the acupuncture train. Mm-hmm. I can't wrap my head around somebody sticking needles in me, so I would never do it, but she is full on the acupuncture train for sure. And again, and that's kind of what brings me back to, and I know that there's a little bit more research proving the effectiveness of acupuncture versus some of the other alternative therapies, but this kind of brings me back to, if it works for you, then it works for you. And exactly. Even if, you know, going to acupuncture was enough to make my mom relax enough so that her muscles relaxed so that her migraine stopped. Great, because it worked. So whether it was because scientifically someone stuck a needle in her temple or if it was because she just chilled the fuck out, which my mother needs to do for the record.
Yeah.
I'm high strung for a reason, people. like, you know, it just for whatever the reason was. You know, it worked. So huzzah, whatever works for you.
So this is a demon that I'm probably going to be fighting for a while. It doesn't seem like there's a quick answer, but at least I'm acknowledging that it's there and I want to fix it. I want to try to take it away from my existence.
Which, yeah, again, good, positive movement, I think, for all of us. We've got so all the resources that we talked about for Demons of the Week this week are actually going to be up at JocePlays.com because we are going to have weekly blog posts, which also post the episodes. So look for that probably on we record on Tuesdays. So look for those on Wednesdays at JocePlays.com. It will be right there on the homepage. So I think that's going to bring us to our listener feedback section. We got, again, this is from our Discord channel, which is discord.gg. I almost said .com, but it's not .gg /JocePlays. And this one comes to us from Hachikumo. If you have a demon, you can either send it in through Discord or you can send it in to us at demonspodcast@gmail.com. But this one comes to us, like I mentioned, from Hachikumo on Discord. It says, I wonder whether religion and demon slaying can be good complements to each other. Of course, different religions preach different approaches to our flaws, but I'm interested in what people think or have experienced. I personally think of it as introducing a demon to fight another demon, though. Is that weird? So I thought this was kind of an interesting, interesting thought. Because, and I thought it was a good fit for this show as well, because I think on this show we tend to talk about things that we wouldn't in other forums. So generally, I know I personally stray away from religion and politics, because those are kind of the two big, really divisive topics. But I thought, you know, the three of us are very level-headed, open-minded, nice people, so I feel like we can get through this conversation without offending anyone too much, but I mean, that's always a potential problem, right? But I thought it was an interesting topic of discussion, really, is when you are dealing with personal flaws, is religion a viable thing to turn to?
I want Nevermore to hit this one, because I've been talking a lot.
So wait, what are we comparing about it?
Just talking about, like, if religion is a good tool to help you deal with your flaws.
And demons.
And demons, yeah.
And his argument is that it could arguably be a demon trying to exorcise a demon.
Mm-hmm. So replacing one thing with another.
As somebody who's not, like, I mean, I grew up in the church. We did vacation Bible school, stuff like that. You know, we were in junior high, like, all, you know, groups and camps and things, whatever. I think it's kind of the same type of answer of if it works for you, because to me, in my experience, I feel like if I was going there for help and whatever, it's not the environment for me, mm-hmm. from what I've personally experienced. And I'm just saying that is, in my experience, that's where I've met the most judgmental people. And I don't mean that, I'm not saying that's bad about anybody. I mean, I know there are churches who are welcoming or whatever, but just the experiences I've had in the past, that's where I've seen a lot of the talking about people behind their back and, you know, things that it's like, you're supposed to be representing this whole experience, but you're not, kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So for me, I wouldn't seek that route of help. You know, I believe what I believe, but I just, actual like church foundation things going to, that's not my style, at least. So
I think that there,
but I see where he's coming from.
Yeah. I think there's a really big difference between being spiritual, being religious, and being organized religious. I think that those are really three different things. I think that you can be a spiritual person and believe in something more than yourself and believe in the unknown. And I think you can be a person who identifies specifically with a religion. For instance, my family is Anglican. I was brought, I guess, I can't remember what it's called in the States, but it has a different name. But Church of England, anyways, is what it is. And so it's basically Catholicism. Mm-hmm. I'm just not Catholic. I'm Protestant. But, you know, so I think that you can be religious without believing in church and, you know, the ways that, you know, you are kind of forced into a certain way of thinking. And then I think you can be in an organized religion where you have very, very strict beliefs and practices and you do X, Y, and Z. I think those are three different kinds of people and different kinds of conversations. And again, this kind of goes into what we were talking about a little bit earlier. And Jules, I'm glad you picked this demon this week, because I think it led really nicely into this, is if it works for you, great. But I do believe it's very easy to lose yourself into the negative parts of some of those communities. And I think that it doesn't matter which community you belong with or if you don't believe in anything, because there are obviously those people as well. I was mostly speaking about people who do believe in something, but I think you can, whether you are spiritual, non-spiritual, religious, non-religious, organized religion, whatever, it's easy to fall into the negative parts of that community, period. So. Yeah. It's not like I'm saying one is better than the other by any means. Just there are many different groups of people, and all groups of people have negative parts. So I think as long as you remain open to the fact that there could be something negative about the community you are a part of, then you're less likely to fall into that. And I think the negative parts of the community is basically what creates the demon. So as long as you are aware that there could be a demon there, then if it works for you to help you fight your demons, then great. But be aware that any group of people can have negative aspects.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, when someone's in crisis, they're very, very susceptible to falling into a place that will help them. You know, something that will give them answers and something that will give them guidance. And I have a very big problem with anything that deals in absolutes. And so that's a lot of organized religion, unfortunately, is that it is this way and it is no other way. And so that's why I consider myself a spiritualist. I was raised Jewish. I did not attach to the religion spiritually. I just didn't because it dealt with absolutes and I couldn't deal with that. And I think that that's what happens to a lot of people is that they say, and what Nevermore was talking about is that my way is the only way. Therefore your way is wrong. And therefore I judge you because you are wrong. Mm-hmm. And, that in itself is a demon. Mm-hmm. I think, I mean, it feels like people sometimes wield that demon and say, I am right and you are wrong and I don't want to hear what you have to say. And I'm willing to listen to anybody as long as they're not dealing in absolutes and in a closed mind. So if you were turning to religion to help you, and I've seen it happen where people were just desperate for something to support them, you know, a kind pastor who listened. And it didn't necessarily have to do with the religion itself. It was just someone with compassion and a kind heart who wanted to listen for free. And that is a big thing for a lot of people. And sometimes those resources are the only things that you have because religion is free. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to memberships and whatever, but you could literally walk into any church on any street, sit down and listen. So that's where, personally, I tend to, say that I don't feel that religion is the be all end all for trying to slay a demon, but it certainly has a lot of guiding factors to get you there. Mm-hmm. You know, if you were struggling with something horrible, like you had, the inclination to harm someone or abuse a child or something like that, and you went to your church and you said, please help me. You know, please listen to me. Then, you know, a good spiritual religious leader is going to sit down and say, we're going to help you. And so that's my thought on it. I, again, very high level, but I completely agree with Jocelyn. If it works for you and you feel comfort and guidance from it, I have no problem with that.
All right. We all agree. This is awesome. Not that I expect to disagree with you guys on too many topics, but religion is always one of those things that can be very polarizing. And as a, like I mentioned, my family is Anglican, but I am by no way or shape or form religious. I would consider myself probably a spiritual person at best, but even then it's not part of my life. I don't give it a lot of thought. But I understand that there are all kinds of people out there with all kinds of beliefs. And like you said, as long as you are non-judgmental and open-minded, then we're going to get along just fine.
Yeah. And I think that's what we all share, right? Mm-hmm. We, you know, in this community too, we all kind of share that feeling of we may not be the same, but we accept you for being different and we accept you for being who you are.
Right.
Because the three of us are very different human beings, but we have this crazy amount of respect for each other and our quirks and our differences
and our crazy personness
and their craziness, you know, because we each have our own brand of crazy. You'll get to see more of it as we do this show.
Yeah. On that note, I should remind everyone that you can follow us on Twitter at Demons Podcast. Nevermore, where can people find you?
You can find me on Twitter at Quota Nevermore. And you can also find my Etsy shop, geekasylum.etsy.com. And that's pretty much it, other than the Discord, which we posted the link to.
Excellent. And Jules, where can folks find you and everything you're up to?
On Twitter, you can find me at JulesRPG, and you can find my other show, Tauren Think Tank, which is at Tauren Think Tank on Thursdays, twitch.tv/Tauren Think Tank at 8 o'clock Central Daylight Time. Yeah, I should also mention too, and I don't say this very often, but I am a personal life coach as well. So if there are any interested people in talking with me about that kind of thing, you can just send me an email. You can send something to the demonspodcast@gmail.com and Joss can get it to me. But I'm happy to talk with people if you've got stuff going on that you just want to work through.
Excellent. And I very much recommend it as someone who talks to Jules often to get through some of the stuff that I'm dealing with. Definitely. She's a good get you on the right path kind of a person. So I can recommend her services very, very highly. You can find me, Jocelyn, and my particular brand of crazy on Twitter and Twitch. I'm at Joss Plays, and you can also find other stuff that I do at jossplays.com, as well as all of the posted episodes of Slaying Demons, which officially has been approved on iTunes. The first two episodes are up. Yay. I double check before the show. We also have a playlist over on YouTube if you'd like to watch the edited VODs. And also the unedited VODs are on my Twitch channel. So make sure you are checking all of that out. That is going to do it for us tonight. Thank you guys so much, and we will see you next week.